If you think the story of Annie Malone is just about an orphanage, you don't know much about Annie Malone.
Oh, there's a huge story.
She was born and raised in Metropolis, Illinois, but came to St. Louis to seek her fortune, producing a line of hair care products for African-American women that would enrich her life and theirs.
A wonderful great hair grower was the name of her beauty product, and it replaced all kinds of other fairly macabre treatments for hair. Eventually, though, she really figured out how to make this into a really successful business.
Eventually, she would create an entire line of beauty products called Poro, and she also started Poro College in North St. Louis to train her salespeople and produce her products.
By the 1930s, she had representatives in every state of the Union. She had representatives in Canada, the Philippines, and a number of other foreign countries, and became extraordinarily wealthy.
And she used that wealth for good, contributing to many African-American causes and institutions, including the St. Louis Colored Orphans Home, later renamed the Annie Malone Home.
She was certainly a model and certainly an exception to her times. Both as a female and an African-American, she faced all kinds of sort of hurdles to success. She overcame them all, became one of the wealthiest women in the United States, and she remained particularly interested in women's issues and in children's issues.
Despite her success, the person best known for helping pioneer the business of African-American beauty products is Madam C.J. Walker. But what's not widely known is Madam Walker received her training at the beauty college run by Annie Malone.